want somebody to talk to. Someone that's on my mind. I want something that's all cool. And it don't waste my time. Yeah, I just want somebody. Anyone else hate traditional bras? I just feel like they're always showing underneath of my strapless tops or my backless jumpsuits, and it's just so stressful to find a braless solution that actually works. Today, I am talking all about my best kept fashion secrets when it comes to best bras to wear underneath clothes. First thing I like to do when I come home is to take off my bra, and I really just don't like how restrictive a traditional bra feels. One of my most frequently asked questions is, Allie, what do you wear underneath that dress? Like, what kind of bra are you wearing? One of my best kept fashion secrets is the stick-on adhesive bra. I just picked this one up from Amazon, and it's really cool because there's no adhesive on the center part where your nipple would usually go, and it has an extra piece of adhesive on the top so it can give your girls a little something really lightweight. Even on a sweaty day, they still stay on really nice and secure. So highly recommend these. I'll link them down below. I know I'm going to be wearing a ton of dresses, and one of my pet peeves is wearing a sticky bra underneath all of my dresses, because when it's hot out, my sticky bra will fall down. It'll like slip to the ground. It looks really awkward when I pick it up and I go, oops, sorry. I deeply appreciate when a dress has built-in boob pads, because I don't have to worry about my bra slipping out or my sticky bra falling off. Everything is nice and secure. I'll link it for you guys down below. So the next time you go shopping for a summer dress, find one with built-in boobie pads like this one. When it comes to backless jumpsuits, I often wonder, like, what type of bra should I wear underneath that? So I found this one off of Amazon again. It has a lower V cut in the front, or U cut. This just adheres on the side of your body, so it keeps everything looking nice and seamless on the back of your outfit. So I would highly recommend this if you want a little bit more support and an oomph for your girls. If you're part of the itty bitty titty committee and you got nothing going on in the front, this is another great dress that I would recommend for you for a graduation, wedding, or any formal occasion. I really love the deep V neckline. I think it's very sexy, still super flattering. If you don't have big boobs, it still looks really flattering on you. Another great way to go braless this summer is by picking items with a lot of pattern. So I've been obsessed with this gingham dress. It's so cute and dainty. I love the little shoulder details. But best of all, because the pattern is so darn busy, you can't even tell that you're not wearing a bra, which is why this dress is. When I'm lounging around at home, I love to reach for an oversized hoodie like this. Well, not too cropped at least. This is another clothing item that you can go braless in and feel super comfortable. Just a pair of leggings and hoodie. Denim is just one of those fabrics that I really love to let my girls hang out free during the summertime, because it's so thick but still very breathable at the same time. So first I'm going to fold my bandana in half into a triangle, and then I'll fold it again, and then again once more, and then one more time. Now taking my bandana, I'm going to wrap it around my neck just to add a little bit of stylized flair to this look.
taking a belt now, I'm just going to add this around my waist area to define the look so I don't look like a giant denim bag. There we go, we finished off my Canadian tuxedo just with a few accessories. For shoes, I have these mules from Madewell. They're super comfy with a giant chunky heel so I can walk all day in them, eat barbecue, do anything I want. I've talked about this before, but I'll say it again. I love wearing swimsuits underneath of my clothes because of the fact that it has this padding on it, it's strapless, and it pretty much goes underneath a lot of great summer tops when it's hot AF outside. So these two are just really affordable ones from Target. I'll link some of my favorite swimsuits down below so you guys can shop these if you'd like. Growing up, I never felt very confident with my chest because I was always part of the itty bitty titty committee. There was really nothing going on there compared to my sister who got blessed with the big boob gene. She is so lucky. Whereas I have always had to find different ways to stuff my bra or different hacks or tips to make my boobs appear bigger because generally speaking, bigger boobs in the American culture, and I guess any culture really, highlights femininity, and I never really felt feminine because I have smaller boobs. Thought like, oh, maybe if I got bigger boobs I would feel more confident, but lately there's been more people talking about breast implant illness that really scared me away from even wanting the surgery at all. I don't think I will be getting it because it's scary and I don't want to introduce this silicone product in my body, potentially get infections and whatever crazy complications that could happen. So hopefully through today's video, you learned a few tips and tricks to feel more confident rocking what you have. Be sure to check out any of my other style hack videos because I love practicing creativity and sharing different style ideas. I love you guys all so, so much, and I hope to see you in my next video. Bye. Bella's so excited for the fact that I don't have to wear a bra either. She's like, yes, free the nipple. Bella, will you go on a picnic with me to Golden Gate Park?